Iowa, Adam Saxon with Guy Cuban. In this video, we're gonna answer the web's most searched questions about Power BI. Let's do it. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and this guy. Now, if you've been watching us for a little bit, you know that I am a big advocate of Bing. However, for this video, I'm going to break that rule. I am going to use Google just because when I was, you know, just poking around to see what things were out there, like autocomplete had some more interesting things there. So enough all this talking, let's head over to my desktop. So the first thing we're gonna see is what does Power BI stand for? Ooh, Power BI stands for analytics, finding out your data, right? That's an easy one. What does Power BI cost? So this is a great question. There's Power BI Free, there's Power BI Pro and Premium per user that are named licenses that you can buy for individual users. And then there's Power BI Premium Capacity, which allows you to scale when you get a large number of users. So it helps with a lot of distribution and also to scale up if you're using large amounts of data. So typically larger enterprise customers will use Power BI Premium Capacity. The breakpoint from a cost perspective on that is typically around 500 users of where it makes more sense to get Power BI Premium Capacity instead of Power BI Pro if you have that many users. So check out a video I did on what is Power BI Premium for more info. How does Power BI work? Well, it's a cloud service and uses the magic of Microsoft's Azure platform to do its thing. It is amazing. How does Power BI connect to SQL Server? It depends on where SQL is. If we're talking about an on-premises SQL Server, you're gonna have to use the on-premises data gateway to connect to that. If you're using something like Azure SQL Database, Power BI can just connect directly to that, assuming you know your firewall is not blocking it or you don't have it inside of a VNet. If you do, then you're gonna either need the on-premises data gateway and or a VNet gateway. How does Power BI forecasting work? So I'll link to a doc in the descriptions. The forecasting itself uses a exponential smoothing algorithm, but this is part of the analytics pane and it only works for line charts. So you're probably gonna do something with a time series. And if you have a line chart on that analytics pane, you will see the forecasting options. How does Power BI store data? So I'm gonna link also to the Power BI security white paper, which goes into all of the details about where data is stored. It's gonna use the Azure infrastructure. So it's gonna use Azure Data Lake storage. As part of that, there is encryption that goes on for data at rest. You can learn all about those details in that security white paper. All right, can Power BI, I like this one. There's a lot of good stuff here. So can Power BI write back to databases? It depends. Power BI natively itself will not be able to write back to databases, but you can embed something like a Power App in a Power BI report, which will allow write back. The other thing that will enable some write back capability inside of Power BI is using custom visuals. So something like the Power On visual will allow you to do that. So you can go check that out. There are some costs associated with those custom visuals. Can Power BI send automated emails? Yes and no. So I guess it depends. It sends automated emails for like failures, things of that nature. You can set up alerts from a Power BI dashboard, not a Power BI report, but a Power BI dashboard on some tiles where it will automatically email you. You can set up a subscription, which can have a schedule associated with it. So that can be automated. And then the other thing you can do is use Power Automate. And so Power Automate has a lot of functionality that you can hook into Power BI and then send emails associated with that. Can Power BI run on a Mac? No. Not even an it depends. I did a video a while back called Power BI on a Mac question mark. It was a long time ago. That video is still valid in terms of the current state. So the direction that Power BI is going is to enable web capability. And so you'll see improvements in the web experience, which will allow you to do things like modeling, Power Query, all of that just in the website alone. So you won't even need Power BI desktops. Can Power BI connect to Snowflake? Yes, absolutely. Power BI comes with a number of connectors that allow you to connect to certain data sources. Snowflake is definitely one of them. It's a very popular one. The thing to realize also is that Snowflake can be deployed in different cloud environments. So you can have it running in Azure or you can have it running in AWS. So if it's running in Azure, treat it like my comments on SQL Server. So you can connect directly, assuming there's no firewall or VNet. If you do have a VNet or firewall, gateway is required. If it's sitting in AWS, then you need a gateway. All right, I'm gonna take the last one here. This will be the last one I answer. Can Power BI handle big data? So I've heard this a couple of times where people are like, oh, Power BI can't scale or Power BI doesn't handle large amounts of data. It absolutely can. However, in order to get that scale, you need to follow best practices for Power BI. And so if you're coming from other reporting tools and just trying to shove that into Power BI, you may not have as much success. So use a star schema in your data, make sure it's modeled correctly, and then you can get to a very large amount of data, so massive data. All right, so those are just a couple of the web's questions or things from autocomplete inside of Google. Let me know if you like this or if you have other questions like that, put them in the comments below. Maybe I'll do a follow-up video of some kind, but hopefully you found this interesting just at a high level, some of the main questions that get asked. If there's something in there, one of those specific questions you want me to do a more in-depth video on, not the Mac video, then put that in the comments below as well. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.